Hi, welcome back. This is Math 0955, section 3.5. Today we're going to introduce yet another form for the equation of a line called the point-slope form. So you can get this equation from the slope formula that we all have. The way it works is you need a slope and a point on the line. So let's give us a line, and let's just pretend we have one point on this line, x1 comma y1, and then we kind of substitute that point into the slope formula. So remember, slope is equal to y2 minus y1. Here we only have one point though, so we're going to leave one of the y's just as y, and then go minus y1 all over x minus x1, and then what we're going to do is multiply both sides by the denominator, the x minus x1. So I'll multiply here by x minus x1, and also multiply here by x minus x1. On the right side, the x minus x1s cancel, and you're just left with x minus x1 times m equals y minus y1, and then you can flip-flop sides. And also, you can put the m in front of the x minus x1. That's the commutative law of multiplication. Basically, 3 times 5 is the same as 5 times 3, that idea. So, and that turns out to be the point-slope form that we are interested in this section. Okay, so that's our point-slope form. So comparing and contrasting, we now have two forms. We have the slope-intercept form. And the slope-intercept form is kind of the most useful form. This is what we want when we're plotting lines. We're getting information about the line. And kind of point-slope is more of a means to an end, in my opinion. So you'll be given some information, and you could set up point-slope form, but ultimately we'll want to convert point-slope form into the slope-intercept form, and you'll see that happen a lot in the exercises. Okay. So the beginning exercises there are on the right. What's going to happen is they'll give you some information, and it's kind of a bit like a puzzle, right? They give some information, and you provide the equation of a line based off that information. Okay. Okay, so that's the spiel, so to speak. Let's look at question one. They're giving us a slope, and they give us a point on the line that we desire. And it's basically, at this point, it's just a plug and chug into the formula. So whenever I do these, I mean, you got to have that formula memorized. So I just write it out, reminding myself the formula. And hopefully after a while, you won't have to kind of revisit the formula anymore. You'll have it memorized. You will need it memorized for the test, okay? Okay, so this is my x1, this is my y1, and the coordinate, and the slope is given. So it'll be y minus the 6 equals 3 times x minus the 3. And that's what they want in that first answer. Sometimes they want you to simplify a bit, like if you have a double negative, they'll want you to change it into a positive, but they don't want you to distribute, which I know is going to be a little bit weird in the homework. They tend not to want you to simplify it first, even though it does say simplify your answer. It doesn't mean to distribute. Okay, so once you get your hands on this form, you're hoping to turn it into slope-intercept form. So we have first point-slope. And then you convert that into slope-intercept. And the way you do that conversion is by solving for y. Okay. So I want to isolate this y variable. And in doing so, I'm also going to distribute on the right side. So first I'm going to distribute. That's part of our strategy of solving equations applied to this scenario. So distribute 3x minus 9. And then I'm going to add the 6 to both sides. I'm running out of room, so I'm going to move over here. And I get y equals 3x minus 3 for my slope-intercept form. Okay. All Okay, and that's the idea in this first set of problems. Let's look at number three, because it has a bunch of negatives floating about, and that sometimes is troublesome. So here they give you a slope is negative 6, and then they're going to give you a point negative 9, negative 6. And I'm going to remind myself of the formula. This is x1, this is y1, and I'm just plugging and chugging. I have to be careful with the signs, though, right? So it's y minus negative 6. And then I have the m is negative 6 times x minus negative 9. So when they want you to simplify for the point slope, they basically just mean to turn double negatives into positive. Like that. And then put in your slope-intercept form, y plus 6 equals negative 6 times x plus 9. Parentheses, and then check your answer. And then again, they want you to convert over to the slope-intercept form. So first I'm going to distribute. And then I'm going to move the 6 over to isolate the y. And that should do it. Okay. Y equals negative 6x minus 16. Great. Okay. More of that material. This one's a little weird because when... Okay, so I'll show you. So again, they're giving us a slope. And they're giving us a point. And, you know, here's my slope, point slope form. And then you're plugging and chugging. Okay, and then you're simplifying a little bit. And it's like sometimes in, when I was going through the homework in like one question, they marked me wrong because I simplified y minus 0 into just y. All right. So what I would recommend is if you have that case and you're trying to simplify, the only thing you want to simplify are the double negatives. Okay. So turn minus 9 into plus 9 and then put that form in there, even though it's kind of odd. The computer, you know, is not a human at this point. It's still, well, learning human intelligence, and it's not perfect, so you have to kind of make it fit. So rather than putting in y instead of y minus 0, just go with the flow, put in y minus 0, whatever makes the computer happy. And then to simplify, you know, now you can go y minus 0 is y, and then we're going to distribute here. And you should be just one step this time, and you're home free. Oops, minus 72. Okay. This is throw some fractions in there to make your life a little bit more difficult. Let's try number 6. So we get the slope of negative 2, and then the point on the line, negative 3, comma, negative 3 halves. So again, the formula y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. So here we go, y minus, this is my x1, this is my y1, so minus negative 3 halves equals negative 2 times x minus negative 3. Get rid of those double negatives. And then go at it. So it's a bit arbitrary, the standardization, and it's one of those things that's going to get on your nerves. But and when you think about any language that you learn, it's kind of like that. If you ever had to learn a foreign language, there's things about the ordering of the phrase that is just arbitrary. I mean, no matter how you order it, you're going to get your point across, right? Like if I gave you a couple of words, like the food eats cat, you know, something like that. You kind of can reconcile the phrase to mean that the cat's eating food. Clearly, the food's not eating the cat. But in English, you know, we have to say it in a certain order, just so, I don't know why, just for the administrative purposes, for putting things in forms and documents, that sort of stuff. You know, taxes has to be in a special form. It's just for dealing with large groups of people. I'm sure, you know, thousands of years ago, they didn't have to deal with it. But yeah, so it's a bit arbitrary, but that's just kind of the way things are for communication purposes amongst large groups of people. It's kind of sad, but there it is. Negative 2x minus 6. So I apologize for how arbitrary some of this stuff is. But anyways, we kind of have to do what we got to do. Here we are at y equals negative 2x, and then we have minus 6 minus 3 halves. Let's get a fraction here, minus 6 over 1, and then multiply top and bottom by 2. So it's going to be minus 12 halves, minus 3 halves, and then simplifying is going to be minus 2x minus, I guess, 15 halves. Okay. Y equals minus 2x minus 15 halves. I hope that's right. Okay. Here's kind of a tricky one. They give you the slope, and then they say it passes through the origin. But that's really just kind of the same game we've been playing. So the slope is 1/6. Passing through the origin means that a point on this particular line is 0, 0. Okay, and then it's just plug and chug, right? So y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. So it would be y minus 0 equals 1/6 times x minus 0. And literally put that in. This is another one of those. It's just, it kind of makes no sense to do this, but here we are. 1/6 times x minus 0. There it is. Okay. And then just simplify it. So it's just going to be y equals 1/6x when everybody's, when all is said and done. Okay. Same junk here with a fraction. That'll make life a little bit more miserable for you. Let's look at number 8. So we have a slope is negative 1/5, and then the 15 negative 7ths is our point. So again, reminding myself of the formula so I don't forget it. I want to memorize that thing. And then plugging and chugging, I have y minus negative 7 equals negative 1/5 times x minus 15. Get rid of the double negatives. And then plop it into your computer. And hope it's right. Yay. And then solve for y. So we'd have y plus 7 equals negative 1/5 x from this distribution. Then this distribution, you know, it's negative 1/5 times negative 15. That's the same as, you know, negative 1/5 times negative 15 over 1. 15 over 5 is the same as 3 over 1. So that's going to be negative, negative is positive. 3 times 1 is 3. 1 times 1 is 1. That's just 3. So that will be plus 3. And then you're minusing 7 on both sides. You get y equals negative 1/5 x minus 4. Hope it's right. Yay. Okay, so now we're into kind of a different class of problems. They're going to give you 2 points, and you have to basically you're going to need to get a slope, and then you're going to need to put the slope and one of the points into your equation. Okay, so it's, so before they're giving a slope and a point, now they're just giving you 2 points and saying, you know, good luck. The way to do it is to first get the slope from the points. So this harkens back to when we first learned about slope. To find the slope, you just go y2 minus y1. all over x2 minus x1. So it'd be negative 15 all over 2 plus 3, which is negative 15 all over 5, which is negative 3. So now you have a slope and a point, right? You have 2 points, but really you only need one of the points. You could use either point. It doesn't matter. But once you get your hands on those objects, then, you know, you could plop it into your point slope form, right? So y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. We'll use this as y, x1, use this as y1. So you have y minus negative 3 equals negative 3 times x minus 2. Just plug and chug. Get rid of the double negatives. Slap it into our computer. Then solve for y. So first distribute. Then move the 3. And you should have it. Okay, so, you know, so on and so forth. And of course, they're going to start throwing fractions in the mix, which will be a real bummer, but, you know, it's just the way it is. Let's try, I guess, number 13. So it's another one of these where they give you 2 points, and you have to basically use the points to get the slope, and then you could use the slope and then one of the points. Ruh-roh. This one's going to be a little different. So negative 1 minus negative 1, that's going to be 0, right? So negative 1 plus 1, the double negatives is a positive, 5 plus 7. It's going to be 0 over 12, which is 0. So the point slope, again, you're just taking one of the points, whichever point you want, and then the slope and plopping it into your formula. So y, let's just cut to the chase, minus y1. And then that equals the slope, which is 0, times x minus 5. So this would be y plus 1 equals 0 times x minus 5. So literally write that in to the computer. The computer is very, very literal. If you tell it time flies, it'll be like, where's its wings? You know? Ruh-roh. So I'm glad I did this. Oh, it's x minus 5. Then you simplify. So multiplying distributing that 0 is just going to give you 0, right? It's just going to be 0 times x is 0. 0 times negative 5 is 0. So you get y plus 1 is 0. Move the 1 to the other side. So you get y is negative 1. And so it's a horizontal line. That's a different, problem there. Okay, so now, again, they kind of give you some different bits of information. Problem 14, they tell you one of the points, and then they're telling you there's an x-intercept of negative 1. But you could use that intel to just get another point, right? So an x-intercept means if it's negative 1, your x-intercept is located at negative 1. 0. You can literally plot it, right? This is x-intercept is negative 1. It's right there. What's the coordinate of that point? Well, it's negative 1, 0. Okay, great. So you got 2 points. You can get the slope from that. So 0 minus 9 all over negative 1 minus 4. So that would be negative 9 over negative 5. In other words, 9 fifths. And then you just take one of the points and the slope and plop it into your formula, y minus y1 equals slope times x minus x1. Get rid of the double negatives for the computer. So we have to make the computer happy. So it's y minus 0 equals 9 this, arrow times x plus 1. And then distribute and simplify. So y minus 0 is just y. 9 fifths times x is 9 fifths x. 9 fifths times 1 is just 9 fifths. So that should do it there. So it's just, you know, they're giving you these kind of puzzle questions, but you can just turn it into kind of what we've already been playing around with. So for this one, you know, you would get 2 points. Basically, the x-intercept they're telling you is negative 2/3. So the first point would negative 2/3, 0. And then the second point for the y-intercept, 0, 5. And then you just use that to get your slope. Maybe a little funny because of that fraction. So the numerator 5 minus 0, the denominator 0 minus negative 2/3. So to look funny, 5 all over 0, negative negative is positive 2/3. This will be 5 over 2/3. How do I rewrite that? Well, just, you know, think of that, this division symbol as divided by. Okay. In other words, you could rewrite the expression as 5 divided by 2/3. And then to do multiplication, when you're given division, you just multiply, change the division to multiply, and take the reciprocal of the second number. Okay. And then it's just multiply straight across. If you want to, you can rewrite 5 as 5 over 1. But it would be 15 halves for your slope, ultimately. And then you go to your point-slope form. I'm going to use the point that doesn't have the fraction, kind of avoid the trouble. So I'd have y minus y1 is 5 equals 15 halves times x minus x1. And that would be what I'm putting in there. Y minus 5 equals 15 halves times x minus 0. And then simplify it, solve for y. So you get y minus 5 over here. 15 halves times x is 15 halves x. 15 halves times 0 is just 0. And then add the 5 to both sides. So you get y equals 15 halves x plus 5. Okay, so now we've got some kind of review questions. The equation of the line is given below. Find the slope of the line that's parallel to the given and then perpendicular. So first identify the slope. So in this problem, the given slope is 5. So a slope that's parallel has a slope of 5. And then a slope that's perpendicular, you just take the reciprocal and make it negative. So the reciprocal of 5 is 1 over 5, and then putting a negative in front of it, negative 1 over 5. Same deal here. So again, the slope in this case for number 19, the given slope of the line, you just look at whatever's in front of the x. Sorry, my pen's died again. So number 19, what do I say? The slope is given as negative 6/5. So a line that'll be parallel, it will also have that slope. And then the negative reciprocal, you just negative negative becomes positive 6/5, and then flip it 5/6, and that should be it. This one you have to first solve for y. So problem 20, I got 9x plus y is 3. So move the 9x. So you get y is negative 9x plus 3. So that tells me the slope here is negative 9. So the slope of a line that's parallel to this guy will also have a slope of negative 9. And then the perpendicular probably. Yeah, so you just you know, negative 9 is the same as negative 9 over 1. Flip it, make it negative, so it would be 1 over 9. Negative, negative, positive. Same game here. So first you got to solve for y. There'll be some division involved. So 21, 2x plus 6y is 18. Move the 2x over. So you get 6y is negative 2x plus 18. And then divide everything by 6. So you get y is negative 2 over 6 is the same as negative 1 over 3. And then 18 over 6 is 3. So the line has slope negative 1/3. So a line that's parallel to it has the same slope, negative 1/3. And then the reciprocal would be 3. And then negating it, it used to be negative, now it'll be positive. Same problem here. This one is a little weird because the given line is vertical, so it doesn't have a slope. So again, if you're not sure what that thing is, just do a little table. X is always negative 1. And then you could draw the thing. So negative 1, 0, negative 1, 1, negative 1, 2. You have this vertical line. And the slope is undefined. So for any line that's parallel to this line, its slope 2 will have to be undefined because it's going to be vertical. So you just click undefined for parallelness. Then for perpendicularness, if you think about what kind of line is perpendicular to that given line, well, it has to be horizontal. And we know that horizontal lines have a slope of 0. So the slope here of a perpendicular line is just going to be 0. All right, write an equation and point slope form for the line that's parallel to the given line. So in this question, the given line has a slope. The given line is y equals 3x, right? We want to create a line that is parallel to that line, but then goes through the given point that you can see on the graph. So first off, the slope of this line is 3. That tells me, because my line is parallel, that my slope has to also be 3. And then if you look on the graph, the point given on the red line, which is the line we want, is 3, negative 2. And so all you have to do is take that information and plop it into the famous point slope form. And then chug away, right? So first they want the equation in point slope form. So y minus negative 2 equals 3 times x minus 3. So this will be y plus 2 equals 3 times x minus 3. Don't distribute yet. So y plus 2 equals 3 times x minus 3. And then they probably want you to solve for y. Yeah. Okay, so distribute the 3. Move the 2. And then you are good to go. Where's my y? Y equals 3x minus 11. Same game here, except now the line that we want to create is perpendicular to the given line. So 25, let's see if there's maybe a more challenging version of this. No, that's pretty much it. Okay, let me go back to that. Right, so the line given is y equals 2x. Its slope is just whatever in front of x, so that's 2. So our line, because it's perpendicular, has a reciprocal, the negative reciprocal. So the reciprocal of 2 over 1 is 1 over 2, and then make it negative. So our slope is negative 1/2. And then the point we see on the line we want is 2, 4. If you just look at the graph, it gives you that point. It's literally labeled. And then you dump it into your formula, y minus y2 equals y1 is equal to negative 1/2 times x minus x1. And then you're just, if you don't mind, I'm going to skip ahead. Okay, this is the same problem, but without the graph, basically. Let's try then 27 here. So they're giving you a point, 5, negative 6, and then they're saying the line we want is perpendicular to this given line, y equals 1/4 x plus 2. So you have a point, you need a slope, but you get the slope from this given information about the perpendicular line, right? So the perpendicular line has a slope of 1/4. That means the slope I want is going to be the negative reciprocal of that. In other words, you flip 1/4, that would give you 4/1, which is just 4, and then you make it negative, okay? So that information is enough to create the equation of a line I want. So it would be y minus negative 6 equals negative 4 times x minus 5. If you look at the directions this time, they want, so we're good. So first they want the point slope form. So get rid of the double negatives. And we have y plus 6 equals negative 4 times x minus 5. Sorry, there's a 5 there. And then we want to solve this for y. So we've got y plus 6 is, distribute, negative 4x plus 20. And then move the 6 over. So y is negative 4x plus 14. And that should do it. Okay. Same kind of problem here. The problem with those is it's a little bit mixed up with regards to the formula given. So you can't just read the slope off the formula. If you see right there, it's x minus 2y equals 9. You got to solve for y first, and then you can get your slope. I just did a perpendicular one. Let's do this parallel version. Okay, so 28. They're telling us the line we want passes through the point negative 2, 3, and it's parallel to the equation 2x minus 3y equals 5. So first, you got to get it into slope-intercept form in order to identify the slope on the line that's parallel to the line we want. So I'm going to move the 2x over. Divide by negative 3. So I just divide every term by negative 3. This will be negative 2x over negative 3x is just 2/3 x. And then positive 5 over negative 3 is minus 5/3. And so the slope here is 2/3. And because this line is parallel to the line we want, we know that our slope must also be 2/3. And so we have our point and our slope. And we could dump that into our point slope formula. Y minus 3 equals 2/3 times x minus negative 2. So I have y minus 3 equals 2/3 times x plus 2. And then you could distribute. They want us to put our answer, our point slope form in first. So y minus 3 equals 2/3. Times x plus 2, parentheses, check that, and then solve for y. Okay, so I have y minus 3 equals 2/3 times x is 2/3 x, 2/3 times 2, 2 times 2 is 4, all over 3 times 1 is 3, and then add the 3 to both sides. So y will equal 2/3 x plus 3 is the same as 3/1, I need a common denominator. So it would be 9/3 plus 4/3 is 13/3. And that should do me. So y equals 2/3 x plus 13/3. Check my answer. Yay. All right. That's the same problem, except the line they give you is perpendicular. 30. Same kind of problem, except instead of giving you a slope, they're telling you the line has the same y-intercept. So a little bit different, but not really. Let's take a look at it. 30. They're saying the line goes through 2, 4 and has the same y-intercept as the line x minus 2y equals 8. Okay. So first I get the y-intercept from this line, so I'm going to have to move the x over to get it into slope-intercept form. Divide both sides by negative 2. In other words, divide every term by negative 2. Negative x over negative 2 is positive x over 2. We'll write it as 1/2 x. And then 8 divided by negative 2 is negative 4. So the slope, we don't care about the slope this time. It's saying that our line has the same y-intercept. And the y-intercept here is negative 4, right? So that's located at 0 and negative 4. And that becomes our useful information. So we're going to use that first point, 2, 4, along with the point 0, negative 4, in order to get the equation of a line. Right. So if we have those two points, we can get the slope. So the slope will be negative 4 minus 4 all over 0 minus 2. That'll be negative 8 over negative 2. Negative by negative is positive. 8 by 2 is 4. And then we have a slope and a point. Let's use the point with the 0. And we can dump that into our point-slope form and go from there. So we have y minus negative 4 equals 4 times x minus 0. Get rid of the double negatives. In this case, you don't have to put the point-slope form. They just want the slope-intercept. So instead of typing in the y plus 4 equals 4 times x minus, they want you to solve for y and then just put that final answer in. So y plus 4 equals distributing 4x minus 0 is just 4x, and then move the 4. So you get y equals 4x minus 4, and that's our answer. Looks like more of this stuff, kind of puzzle questions. 31, they're telling you our line has an x-intercept of negative 4. That indicates to me that I have the point negative 4, 0. And then it's parallel to the line that goes through the points 5, 1, and 4, 4. Okay, so again, I always need two things. I need a point and a slope. I have a point, I just need a slope. And I know my line is parallel to the line with those points. So I can figure out the slope of that line, the given line, then I'm just going to borrow that for my slope. So you have to use a slope formula. 4 minus 1 all over 5 minus 4. That'll be 3 over 1, which is just 3. And once I get that, that's my slope, right? So that will be what I use over here. And I just take this material and plop it into my formula. Again, they don't care that much in this problem about the point-slope form. They just want the slope-intercept. So just solve for y automatically, distributing. And there it is. Yeah. So y equals 3x plus 12. And rock and roll. Rock row. That's what I do. Y equals 3x plus 12. 5, 1, 4, 4. 4 minus 1 is 3. 4 minus 5. Oh, no. 4 minus 5 is negative 1. That's negative 3. Negative, 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 negative. Sorry about that. do then? More of this kind of bizwax. So they're giving us a point, -7, -8, and they say it's perpendicular to a line whose equation is x equals 17. What the heck is that thing? You know? So x equals 17 is going to be a perpendicular line through the point 17, 0. Right? It's a vertical line. If you forget, and then do your little table, you know, all of the x-coordinates have to be 17, and then you're just going 0, 1, 2, or whatever. Plot those points, and you see it's vertical. So a line that's perpendicular to a vertical line is going to be horizontal. In other words, its slope is 0. Okay? So the line we want is perpendicular to that vertical line, so it must have a slope of 0. And now, lo and behold, we have a point and a slope. We can just go to our formula. Y minus 8 is 0 times x minus -7. Get rid of the double negatives. And they just want the equation y equals this time. Distributing the 0 will just make all of that 0. Add the 8 to both sides. And so our answer must be 8. Are we done yet? No, apparently not. How many more problems do I have? Oh, jeez. All right, so the line passes through -6, 4, and it's perpendicular to the line with an x-intercept. So they're just giving you a bunch of information. Again, you need to find a point and a slope. They're giving you a point, -6, 4. And then they're saying our line is perpendicular to the line with an x-intercept of 1. So that's the point 1, 0. And then a y-intercept of -2. So that would be 0, -2. Okay, so what I'm going to do is figure out the slope of this line. So using my formula, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. -2 over -1, that's just 2. So the slope, that tells me then my slope is a negative reciprocal of that. So you flip the 2, the 1/2, make it negative. And there it is, right? That's going to be my slope and my point. Let's go on to the next one just for the sake of my own sanity. Let's see. So the line is perpendicular to the line whose equation is 4x minus 7y equals 21 and has the same intercept. Okay, so as usual, I need to get a point and a slope. And they're not giving you really any information for free this time. They're just telling you the line we want is parallel to the line whose equation is 4x minus 7y equals 21. And it has the same intercept. It's parallel and has same y-intercept. Right, so I think if we just get this equation into slope-intercept form, we could just read off the slope and the intercept and plop it into y equals mx plus b form. All right, so move the 4x, so you get -7y equals -4x plus 21. Divide everything by -7. I get y equals negative by a negative is positive 4/7 x, and then -3. So there it is. I mean, it has the same slope. It has the same intercept. That's the equation. I mean, if you want to go through the rigmarole of it. That tells us, basically, if I go to y equals mx plus b form, sorry, that x is oriented incorrectly, it's the same line. These are both, maybe I could have figured that out if I just thought it through, right? If it has the same intercept, oh, it's perpendicular. Ooh, well, that screws it up a little bit. So our slope is the negative reciprocal, but it still has the same y-intercept. Okay. So then I could just plop it into y equals mx plus b form. Sorry. So this would be -7/4 x minus 3. Y equals -7/4 x minus 3. I was thinking it was parallel. This one is just variables. Okay, so instead of using numbers, you got some variables. Bx plus ay equals d. And they want the slope of a line that's perpendicular to this line. So what you do is get the slope. So all I'm going to do is solve for y. So I get ay equals negative bx plus d. Then divide everything by a to isolate the y and get it into slope-intercept form. So y equals mx plus b form. This will be negative b over a times x plus d over a. So the slope here is that negative b over a. And then the slope of the line that's perpendicular to it, you flip it, so it'd be a over b, and then you negate it. So you make it negative negative, that will be a positive. And then that should be it. Make sure you use capital letters, otherwise it'll flip out on you. And I think that'll do it for chapter 3. Hope this video helps as usual, and I'll see you next time.